Hi guys, today we are going to be doing our unboxing of the stroller that we have picked. And to let you know what we had gotten, we got the YPSI travel system by Perego, made in Italy. Would you like to show us the box?
Yeah.
Yes. So we're going to do our unboxing and our honest review.
Everybody.
There you go. You want to help us? Let's get a box. So first in the box is probably the most used item. I actually have the whole thing. It is going to be the car seats. So this travel system, what we looked on is the travel system, so you can actually use the car seat and use it in the stroller if you buy the adapters. So that's what we're planning on doing, and we can use it when we take the kid to wherever the kid's gonna go for childcare. So, next is, actually it looks like we got a seat part.
Yeah, it's the popper seat.
Yeah. Oh, this one. There. We got cameras each way. So that is the, and we also see, you can see the color we got, we have black. From the YPSI system.
Pretty much, maybe 4 or 5 years.
Yeah, easily.
Yeah.
And this is the
car base.
Car base, yep.
That's the exterior.
Yep, and what's cool about the car base, it's European style.
European grade.
Or approval, yeah. So this comes out as an extra leg that sits down where you normally put your feet in the back seat. And this is where that goes and gets adjusted to the car so you can take it to Europe. Oop. My little helper's here.
Where is it?
That's the skeleton of the whole crib.
Stroller.
Sorry, stroller. No, crib. The handle for the push-to-push. What? And so far unpacking it's pretty straightforward. Everything's right there, ready to go, which I like. They just try to dig it out and, you know, unmock. It's packaged really well.
Yeah.
So.
Oh, does it come with adapters? Aw, snap. No way. These are the premium. Yep, because this is a premium Viago.
Yep.
Primo Viago. Mm-hmm. This is awesome. So these are actually the clips that we need to put in here, the adapter pieces, in order to clip and unclip the car seat. So these can live on the car seat and then they'll clip mm-hmm. and clip out of here. That's so cool. I thought we had to buy those extra.
Yeah. I guess in case they've broken or if you need an extra one or something, that might
maybe
be.
Maybe because it's the travel kit.
Yeah, maybe.
They want to make sure that you use it.
Mm-hmm. And we'll show you guys like detail of each thing too. So these are the wheels. It looks like it's got pretty solid bearings. Built steel axle with the grooves for the locking mechanism. As the tires themselves, they look basically plastic, like a really polymer car plastic. But the good thing about these is one breaks or something happens, gets crushed or whatever, you can replace these for a few bucks, or if it's under warranty, you can get them replaced. So I'm not too worried about that being an issue. More instructions.
Ooh,
this is the brake system. This is what you attach the wheels to. Oh, that's cool. So this is going to attach into the wheels.
Speaking of warranty. The 2-year warranty.
Mm-hmm. That's what you need to do. And these are the front wheels. Straight pegs. They go in there. And they're about, I would say, about 6, 7, 8 inches wide or in diameter. So they're pretty good front ones, not smaller ones. But the same hard plastic. So we got that. And, oh, hey, instructions on how to build it. It releases and does this.
And, yep, that click means that it locked into place. So we're at that step. Mm-hmm. And then from there, what we're going to do is attach the wheel system.
So
your brake system goes in the
back.
It looks like, yep.
So we're doing the back wheels first. Uh-huh. So I got the wheels here first, and it looks like these are the, so I see how that goes.
And you should just clip in.
This should just clip in? Do I have to take these off? Does these look?
So, no, you only, yep, just that one you want to put on the back system. Yep. Nope. Drop the wheel. No one said anything about wheels. Yep. Yeah, that looks right. Perfect. Okay, then after that clicks, we have to click in the front wheels, which are going to be the small ones. Yep. So, oh, you got this. Wait for the click. So you want to make the wheel go the same direction as the frame. Yeah.
I know why.
Oh, there you go.
Yep. That makes sense. Yep. So what they have is what she was talking about. These grooves, they go in with this little latch part here. So I'm going to line it up like that. And I'll give it a nice little tug. So pretty straightforward.
Then once you have the front wheels, it says to go ahead and attach the handlebar at the top. So the handlebar's to the left of you.
Mm-hmm. So there is no orientation. It's basically any way you like
either
it.
Either or, yeah.
Yeah. So put this in there. So it's these two buttons here and here. Boom, boom. Push those in. Use my third hand, and you hear a click, and hear a click, and that's in there now.
Perfect.
Yep.
And then step number 4 actually goes to the netted frame.
Okay. Yep. It has a ski. I was like, why isn't that making any sense here?
Come here.
You're like, I don't even know what's going on.
Curtis. No.
Yes.
He's like, no, thank you.
Oh, here, we got that one in. Good job, babe.
Yeah.
So then you said this part snaps straight to the top part, right?
Yep, and then it folds back.
Like that. Oh, yeah. Look, there we go.
He has a little click.
Yeah, you just pull the fabric and pull down. Makes your life just a little easier. So, and then that part buckles, so you can pull that out front. But then the back side looks like it might work a lot better.
Well, hey, we figured it out. Oh, so that's why there are holes in the bottom.
Mm-hmm. That's why.
I see.
I was like, hey, that makes more sense now.
I thought it was a draining system, I guess.
So, I'm gonna try it. Oh, that one doesn't pull out. These holes are a little bit tinier in the bottom, so a little bit more difficult to play with. So you just gotta take your time and do it.
like trying to put a button on a freaking giant. Alright, so I would like to point out, don't mind me, what I don't like about the setup for this is there's this rubberized material that they use, see the item that is more glossy, it's like reinforced fabric that they put in there right where the buttons are, so I think that's really good product material than just being straight fabric that could possibly be ripped. So, all right, got that situated. What's that?
We snap, yep.
So these are just covers, so you don't need those.
Right here for the basket and the front part, it shows it going into cover the first and second button that you had. Yep, just like that.
Okay, so this is like a...
It's just to secure it in, so that when you add weight to the basket...
it doesn't pop out.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. That's good.
Sorry.
No, it's fine. I just want to make sure everything was going to the right spot. So...
It should be ready for demoing.
Yep, so...
There we go. So...
So give me the base before we put the seats and stuff in. So with this set up, pretty sturdy in my opinion, compared to some of those strollers. Any other features? So to raise these up, it's the two buttons here. So what I like about the extension is not by height, it's more of the, it's more for walking. So if I was closer with my feet are moving, so I had it down in the forward position, I would probably kick that a lot more. So normally I would probably want it fully extended out so that when I'm walking and pushing, my feet are not hitting that,
But if you're just at a grocery store, like, I'll have it all the way down. Because I'm just, like, scooting it.
Scooting, passing,
yeah. Yeah, I don't really need to worry about where my feet are.
So, then you have your tags here for hanging any extra accessory bags or anything. To lock and to unlock is back here. So you just hit this down, it locks both. As you see, it scoots.
Mm-hmm.
Lift her foot up, which I actually like weight. The front one locked.
Is it on my foot?
I don't know. That was locked, so then that's free moving. And that's locked. So there you go. So you put it in a forward position, it locks. So it works. Yeah, so that's basically what it is. So you keep it in sand or snow, it doesn't like roll around or anything. So that's good to know. That's just a switch of the button. And then, easy part, this is the folding mechanism on the YPSI stroller. Also, if you're curious, the Agio is also the same, basically the same stroller. So you come down here, move this, you grab this, you lift up and over. And then there you go, freestanding, and you move it, carry it with you need to go to, into the car, shopping, wherever it deems to be, airports, whatever. And again, lever on this side, you just basically push down, and you bring this around, and it's ready to go, which I like, it's
really simple. And this is the one hand,
tear
down and stand back up. So if your hands are busy.
Yeah, so say still do it easily with that. If I have the kid in this arm, probably I would do this. Fold over, place the kid into the seat or however it's situated.
And how light is that?
This? I want to say 20 pounds with easy movement, so anybody can do it. We tried some other stroller brands. I know the mechanisms to collapsing it was very difficult. Some of them, I think, what was it? What was the big popular one?
There's the Appa and the Cybex were
contenders. Yeah, the Appa definitely weighed like an extra like 10 pounds more. It definitely was heavier.
And the Cybex had like the AABC.
Yeah, it was like you had to do a combination on your stroller just to fold it in. I struggled, so that's something we did not want.
I still was not able to.
Yeah, so that was an interesting day. So, alright, on to the next.
So the next thing that we can do is we can add these attachments to the car seat and then see if it'll clip in.
Yeah. Okay, so with the YPSI and the Argo system with this, so there are these numbers on the side. Just to give it to you, so here and here. So this is that whole one-handed thing. So demonstrate you're holding a kid. How would you want to take, oh, you want to be holding a kid. How easy with one hand to take that car seat out?
Well, you can just feel down here, do the one.
And one is stays permanently up. It's just part of and that feature. Two, and then you can then pull
it
up.
It just comes up.
Yep.
And it can go either way. So I guess we can try to do it this way.
This way. So you do forward facing and front facing and rear facing.
Yeah.
And it's just simple. So easy.
And then there's this mechanism on the back to allow for different tilts.
Yes.
Maybe I'm not good at it.
Turn it up. So I wonder what these are. So these side buttons here, one on each side.
Maybe the car seat doesn't tell.
Yeah, maybe. But I want to move that.
Yeah, I think the car seat's in place. Don't break the vehicles.
Maybe it just goes in the other way. I should be able to tell 40 that way, so. Easy to put the kid in.
Yeah, I don't think it tilts, babe. Okay. Go. You just
The two side buttons. So the orange, the gray buttons right there. Push those in, and then you can tilt it. So you can definitely have it not like interfere in a kid's face or.
And my favorite part is this. Mm-hmm. It's full coverage. This is the netted.
Mm-hmm.
And then it also has a zipper.
So might have to have that up a little bit.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. There you go. Zippers on your side.
Zippers on my side. Mm-hmm. So we'll unzip it and then we'll put these back down.
Mm-hmm. Okay, one more time.
And then it overextends all the way down for complete shade coverage.
So then their little toesies will be shown, but yeah, so you can give them the full protection. So if they're sleeping or, you know.
The farmer's market.
Yeah.
It's very light outside.
Mm-hmm.
Just to help them cool down and stuff.
Yeah.
That's like one of my favorite parts.
Mm-hmm.
These adjust too. They're very flexible.
Mm-hmm.
It has the
3 and 5 point system that we use for America and European standards.
Mm-hmm.
So it's really nice. Is that plastic supposed to be there or no?
These?
No, this plastic. This supposed to be there?
Yeah.
But I think it's an added piece.
Yeah, I think this is.
So it's just a lever in the back.
Oh, I guess.
It should just be three. It should be
it's
like.
Just three. So yeah. This is tilt one.
Mm-hmm. Two.
Tilt two.
And tilt three, yeah.
Yeah.
And then also the full size.
Do what?
Yeah, and clips.
Oh, it does? That's okay. I already got the knife. It's fine.
She's got the knife. Come for you later.
Dakota?
Yeah, we're gonna put them right in the seat. That's cute.
Jeez.
So, okay,
and
so.
This is another product warranty. So mm-hmm. we're gonna fill all these out. There is one with the car seat as well.
Mm-hmm.
We'll just go ahead and mail it in. Yep. It comes with a 2-year product warranty.
Yeah.
Register them and get them out of the way and stuff.
Mm-hmm. So start off with this thing, right? It should just be clips on the inside. So yeah, there's clips right there and right there. So you can take the thing out. So it's easier to get the kit out raw. Or swivel or whatever.
And in the future, mm-hmm. they have clip-in trays for food and drinkies.
Mm-hmm.
So that when they get to that age of feeding themselves, yep. it'll be a lot easier to go to your Auntie Anne's
mm-hmm.
and sneak some pretzels.
Oh, yeah. So.
So that also with this. So this part, so I'm going to tilt it back just one more so you can... See, this part actually takes out.
You just pull it from the top. Yep.
So pull out like that, so it gives them the extra like footrest. So they have that.
Yep. Mm-hmm. And that's supposed to be for why?
For circulation.
For circulation in their legs.
Yeah, because if you see kids like get free a lot, it's actually because they're losing the feeling because they're waiting to sit. But it has their legs propped up a little more and gives a little more flow. So that's that. And then there's a zipper here. What does the zipper do? Clips in. So.
Can you flip the seat with one hand?
Can I flip the seat with one hand?
Yay!
Yeah. So yeah. So there is our YPSI Perego.
Sorry. Perego.
Perego.
Peg. Perego.
Yeah, she's right.
He had to read it.
Mm-hmm. So, and this is our.